In September of 2011, data was released stating that a groundbreaking discovery of neutrinos traveling at above light speeds was made in the Gran Sasso National Laboratory in Italy. These neutrinos are called superluminal because they travel faster than the speed of light. This experiment was called OPERA, or Oscillation Project with a Motion Tracking Apparatus, and in it, thousands of tests of neutrino reactions were collected over several years, the most recent testings at the time validating the suspicion that the neutrinos were arriving at their destination on average 60 nanoseconds ahead of when light would have. This is a huge discovery, and if true, would have a shattering impact on the physics world. Most people are aware of this, and are aware that it would change the way we perceive many of our common physical laws that we take for granted. But what exactly are the implications of this discovery, and how could they impact how we view the universe? To understand exactly what the importance of this discovery is, we must first understand the theory of special relativity itself. Many of us are already familiar with Einstein's theory of relativity. Special relativity is a part of this theory, and states that all uniform motion is relative, and that there is no absolute state of rest. It also states that the speed of light is the same for anyone or anything, no matter how fast it's going. There are three major principles connected to this theory. The first principle is time dilation. This means that time is relative in regards to motion. That is to say, a change in speed of movement means a change in the movement of time. Many of us know that if you are traveling at incredibly high speeds near the speed of light, time moves slower. If a person in a spaceship traveling near the speed of light was in his spaceship for what he perceived would be 13 years, it could be 300 years down on Earth. However, theoretically, if someone is walking their entire life, and another person is sitting in the same spot their entire life, time will also move slightly faster for the person who is sitting, though the change is so small it is negligible and would go unnoticed. The important thing to remember is that time is never a constant, and the closer you get to the speed of light, the slower time moves relative to what's around you. The only exception to this rule is light itself, which will always move at the same relative velocity regardless of an object's motion. The second principle of special relativity is length contraction. The faster something is going relative to you, the shorter it will look. Distance equals rate by time, rate meaning velocity, but time is a variable relative to however fast you are moving. It's not like the person in the spaceship perceiving 13 years to have passed is moving in fast forward in their eyes to catch up with the 300 years that have passed on Earth. No. To them, only 13 years truly have passed, and since time is perceived as moving at the same rate by everyone, the variable that must change is distance, meaning that all distances appear shorter the faster you move. As you approach the speed of light, the universe will contract and the dimensions of objects you observe will change. The distance from point A to B must change so that the perception of time for both observers can be the same while their velocities differ. Distances and time spent traveling approach zero the closer you get to light speed. The third principle of special relativity is relativity of simultaneity. This principle implies that as a result of time dilation and length contraction, different people watching or experiencing the same event will not experience it at the same exact time due to their different positions and relative velocities. So what does this mean for superluminal neutrinos? Well, the key thing is that if anything can travel faster than the speed of light, it defies special relativity, which applies to everything in our universe. It doesn't make sense that something could go faster. If you were able to move faster than the speed of light, you could potentially stop something from happening after you watched it happen. To accelerate something with any sort of mass to the speed of light requires infinite energy according to the theory of relativity, so going faster doesn't even fit into the equation. Any particle with mass must move slower than the speed of light, and any particle without mass must move at the speed of light. It cannot be slowed down or sped up. So to move faster would imply the possibility of negative mass. Simply put, we would have to reevaluate our entire system. There are several theories for what might be happening to cause the neutrinos to be moving at above light speeds. One is that the neutrinos do not travel at above light speeds their entire course, but simply jump a short initial distance of superluminal speed before settling back down to lower speeds. Another theory is that in very high energy collisions, excitations may be shot into bulk space, or a higher dimensional membrane. This wouldn't violate special relativity, as in our dimension they wouldn't be exceeding the speed of light, though it may violate our understanding of how dimensions relate to one another. The thing for certain is that nothing is determined, not even the results of the OPERA experiment. A separate pulse of neutrinos coming from a supernova known as 1987A that was recently analyzed should have shown up years earlier than the star's exploding light if the results of the OPERA experiment were correct. Another margin of error could be due to the fact that when these neutrinos are produced to be tested, they are produced by a pulse of protons, which lasts 10,000 nanoseconds. It is impossible to measure the time of flight of individual neutrinos, so the time of flight of the group of neutrinos is taken. If any of the proton pulse modeling data is incorrect, the neutrino traveling time may also be incorrect. The idea of a particle that moves faster than the speed of light is a tantalizing thought, and is one that is still up for debate. It seems unlikely that something would break so many of our common laws that would work so well with our universe. However, If it were truly proven that this particle could move faster than the speed of light, it could open many new doors on new discoveries in physics and change the way we view our world as we know it.